Hi there, my name is Andy and I'm the founder and CEO of yasoon. I'm happy to show you some project management practices which my team and I have learned along the way of growing together as a successful small-sized company. But let's dive in. The topic of my session today is Organize in Jira, Communicate in Microsoft Teams. So in this session, I will show you why and how we do project management with those two tools. There are plenty of more options on the market, but for us, these two worked really, really well. We are a software company, but for this talk today, I want to focus on the business side of our team. So doing marketing, customer success, partner management, and HR. So there are a whole variety of projects within our small team of just six people. We know many small teams don't use a dedicated tool for project management. Neither did we. They work with simple tools like Calendar and Excel, and it often works more or less. Small teams have to be agile within themselves, and they don't want to lose their flexibility when working with a tool. They think they can rule the chaos. However, flexibility isn't everything when you lose sight of your projects. And that's what happened to us. When we started, we didn't have a proper project management workflow. We mostly used Microsoft Teams, Outlook, occasionally Excel for bigger projects. But with growing projects, we didn't have the structure we needed. And so we looked at different project management tools and concepts. But if we have a small team already huddling through Microsoft Office, implementing a big new project management tool seems scary. The risk of having overhead because of using a new tool doesn't really seem worth it. We also did some research on different project management concepts, and they too seem too big for a small team like ours. In a small team, we do not have a lot of dependencies to others. We just want to get our ideas going as quickly as possible. And tools like Gantt or burndown charts, extended documentation, seems like a lot of overhead without dedicated project manager. Bigger teams might get great value out of these ideas, but for us, this was way too much. So how did we proceed? We wanted just a little bit more structure and a better overview, but still a process that doesn't overwhelm us, a tool that supports us and not captures additional capacity. So we tried to use Jira, which is a commonly used project management tool by Atlassian. It has its origins in software development, but it can be used very flexible for all kinds of teams. We already used Jira in our software team, so we just opened a new board for the business team, while every one of them were still working majorly in Microsoft Teams. And that's how it went.
Sorry, but what was my Jira password again?
Wasn't there something I needed to review?
Okay. One last gift. Just one last gift.
Was it in a Teams chat?
I'm done. What do I do now?
Was it in an email?
So, if anyone would forget their Jira password...
Was it on paper?
Even for our small business team with six team members, it still was chaotic. We now used more tools in different ways without an inherent structure. And we had to admit the nightmare became true. We lost time in tooling and didn't really get anything out of it. But luckily, that's not the end. We challenged the way we work together in those tools, Microsoft Teams and Jira, and found a common sense on how we want to really harvest all the good of each tool, without wanting something in the tool isn't even built for. So we decided to organize, plan, and document in Jira, but we communicate and collaborate in Microsoft Teams. Jira is a strong planning tool made for software companies, but it's also expanded a lot into business teams. You can basically plan everything in Jira. It gives you a sought-out structure out of the box, but it also has a lot of opportunities to tweak your workflows to your own needs. But communicating in Jira isn't smooth at all. We don't want email notifications, nor do we want scattered bits and pieces of text in Jira comments. On the other hand, Microsoft Teams is the king of communication. From the beginning of starting our company, we collaborated in Teams. It offers us the easiest way to connect with our colleagues via chat, have transparent flow of information in Teams channels, and it's also integrated deeply with our file system, Microsoft SharePoint. By combining these two tools, we found a way to create a straightforward project management process for smaller teams. It's a universal process that can be adapted to all kinds of business teams. And for this talk, I want to show you how our actual product system looks like. It's real data, it's our business team's real process, and that's why most of the text you will see is actually in German. First, I will show you how we set up our Jira board and how we use it, with a little hint on how we work with Microsoft To-Do too. Then I will focus on the team side and give you some insights on how we connected all these tools. To give you a mindset about our company, we are a software vendor and we connect Jira and Microsoft 365 tools for a living. Our app, Microsoft 365 for Jira, will be part of this demo. But of course, there are also insights you can take away from this demo without using our app. So let's take a look. So we start in our Jira board. It's based on a software project template because this offers us a little more flexibility than the other ones. And it has the standard columns to do, in progress, and done. Plus an additional column review since there's always a quality control in our business projects. Of course, these columns can be defined differently. That was just a simple, straightforward way for our team. We only work with tasks, and that can be pretty much anything. There's nothing too small, but it should be relevant to the team. We always ask ourselves, if I don't do it, would someone else have to do it? The Jira board offers us a good overview of what is on the plate. When adding Jira issues, we think of bigger chunks of work as an issue to not have too many minor parts on the board. But we also don't want to scale it too big to comprehend. Looking into the task, we added two custom fields, team members and designers. And this is the kind of something that isn't inherent in Jira. Since our board should give us an overview, we have multiple people working on the same issue. These fields enable us to differentiate who oversees that particular issue, the assignee. Who else is working on the issue? The team members. And since pretty much all our business projects involve design in any way, who is the designer on that issue? These custom fields can be different in other business processes. If you have different reviewers, then this might be another field to consider. If you have always must checks for legal, then that might be a field to add to. And since there are different people working on an issue, it is also why it's okay to not scale down too much in the naming of the Jira issue. It can have different steps by different people within itself. This helps our team to keep an overview of what the topics are they are working on, rather than get into all the bits and bobs of everyone's to-do list. To give it some structure, we use labels that match our Microsoft Teams channels. In our business teams, we have different work streams like events, partner management, HR, or content marketing. Each work stream has a Teams channel, and each channel is a label for better filtering options within our Jira board. As for epics, we use them to cluster tasks under a certain topic. For example, we have the label event, we have the epic PM72, this charity event we are doing right now, and we have the task recording a session. The neat thing about epics is their appearance on the roadmap view. If you give them a start and an end date, you get a very good overview of which topics are relevant in which time frame. And you see their progress, of course. In our backlog, we put all the issues that aren't relevant for the upcoming 2 or 3 weeks, but are projects we need to work on in the future. So that's all about our setup. But how do we work with it? In our weekly team meeting, we discuss the topics relevant for the week, so everyone better has their tasks in the board. With our custom JQL filter, every team member can filter on their own task, no matter if they are assignee, team member, or the designer of the issue. When talking about our projects, we like to add our own to-dos in Jira. And since multiple people are working on one issue, there are plenty to-dos that don't really belong into the description and aren't even that relevant for everyone to see. Here we use our own integration between Microsoft 365 and Jira to bring personal to-dos from the Jira issue into any user's Microsoft to-do list. So being in the Jira task, I can just add my personal to-dos and it will sync to my chosen list automatically. Here we are into to-do, and that's really the personal task hub for everybody in the team. It is the personal view and it contains all the work and for some members even the non-work to-dos. You can have different lists, you can plan your day, and the Jira issues are connected for you to easily jump into the board. So to sum it up, Jira is for the team planning and for the project overview. To-do is for the personal planning. Beyond our weekly planning meeting, our team doesn't really need to log into Jira. And that's where the real magic happens. Let's jump to Teams, where we collaborate. With our own app, Microsoft 365 for Jira, we added the Jira board in our team in Microsoft Teams. Within this board, you can work with Jira tasks on a basic level, but we also integrate Jira and all Microsoft 365 tools in a deep way. So you can start working on a task, just drag and drop to the in-progress column. Is there something you want to inform your colleagues about? You can start a Teams channel conversation right in the issue. Tag your colleagues and get the work going. By having it linked to the Jira issue, all our conversations on this topic will be shown in Jira too, automatically synced. So this, thinking back to our weekly meeting or any project meeting, of course, we can jump into the issue to see everything that is discussed about this topic. We like. Let's talk about reviews.
Where the f*** is that review?
So our colleague Britta wrote a blog post about PM72 and it's ready for review. She just jumped in the Teams Jira board right within Teams, drag and drop the issue into the review column and opens it. Right there, she can start a Teams channel conversation, add a briefing for the reviewer, and of course, link the right document of SharePoint. Send and done. Looking into the events team channel, you can now see the reviews posted and it is linked to the Jira issue. Why is this even so important? In our experience, finding reviews or any kind of information in Microsoft Teams is hard. You have different channels, some even drop in via chat, some via email. This makes it impossible to find what needs to be reviewed. By using Jira, in this process, our team lead Anke has a simple column review where she can find her task. And this whole column is also synced automatically into Anke's Microsoft to-do list. We mostly have one reviewer, our team lead, but if you have multiple reviewers, you can of course use the reviewer field in Jira issue and configure your synchronization in to-do accordingly. Maybe a few words on how we try to keep our teams clutter-free, because this is an issue for many teams and relevant too when talking about project management processes. We use the Teams channels for status communication. Every post has a headline, which is the name of the Jira issue, and has someone linked to. If someone should read it, link him. We also link the whole channel if this is an update important for everybody. And we advise from SharePoint whenever necessary. Most times, a channel post is in connection with an issue on our board. So we link the issue when composing a channel post to make the connection visible and to document our findings. Whenever we are just discussing things, we use chats. Individual or group chats. These can be linked to a Jira issue, but of course we don't link every conversation we are having. Some just aren't necessary documenting. One might think now, don't we ever talk to each other face to face or digital face to digital face? Of course we do. Also, we think a good process oftentimes saves you a lot of meetings. Talking to each other is still key in working with our team. We love to sit together, brainstorming, look over drafts, and talk about strategies. But especially when we have an important meeting, we don't want all these valuable findings to be lost. When we plan important meetings like kickoffs, we schedule it within the Jira issue it regards. Our app allows us to find a good date where everyone within the issue is available, and it sends the team's information automatically to all attendees. And in the meeting, everything we discuss will just pop in the meeting chat, and it's in Jira too. So let's sum it up. We started at Microsoft Office Suite Project Management, and when it came to its limits, we bluntly added Jira. But we learned without a proper workflow, every tool will just enhance the chaos. We wanted a process everyone feels comfortable with, and that isn't over-engineered. So people are actually wanting to use it. This process is flexible, but offers us an overview. We wanted to bring our team the organizational power of Jira, but without having them to leave Teams. This project management workflow is easy to implement, easy to understand, and easy to use. And we will never need a dedicated project manager, Scrum Master, or whatever person to just manage our tasks. I hope you got a bit of inspiration on how smaller teams can do project management beyond Excel and Outlook. If you are interested, check out Microsoft 365 for Jira in the Atlassian Marketplace.